وما أرسلنا قبلك إلا رجالا نوحي إليهم فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون.
بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه وموالاه. This is lesson 14. Today, inshallah, we're going to talk about the definition of sound. From this lesson and onwards, we need to pay attention to all the lessons, as the previous lessons was just an information about Tajweed. But from this lesson and onwards, we can start learning what corrects our recitations. Definition of the sound, it is the vibration and waves in the layers of the air that reaches human ear. Human ears hear the sound in the range between 20 to 20,000 vibration per second. Now, how does the sound happens in nature? It happens in four different ways. One, strong collision of between two bodies, like clapping hands, two strong bodies hitting each other and so on. Two bodies parting from each other, where there is a strong bond between them. Example, breaking a piece of plastic or wood. Three, vibration of a body, like thin material vibrated by the wind. Four, strong friction of an object on another object, like cutting wood with a saw. So this is how the sound happens in nature. Now, how does it happen in our articulation components? It happens the same. The unvowed letters are formed by the collision of two components of the articulation point, like M, Eb. Now, there is a collision between the lips. The med letters and the letters of the soft lengthening are formed by vibration of the vocal cords, like qa, qu, qi. Three, vowed letters are formed by parting of the two components of the articulation point, like ba, bu, bi, and so on. These three actions of opening of the mouth, circling of the lips, and lowering of the jaw are amongst the most important methods of tajweed. At the same time, the reader must be careful to pronounce the vowel sound correctly, not to shorten or lengthen them more than they should be. Now, the definition of the harf linguistically means the edge, side, or an end. In Arabic, is called harf because it has two edges, two sides, or two ends. Allah says in the Quran, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى harf. And of people in he who worship Allah on an edge. Its definition in the Sharia, it is a sound that depends on a specific part of the body or approximate part of the body. Specific part means a specific place in the areas of the throat, the tongue, or the tulips. Approximate part means it is not specific place in the areas of the throat, the tongue, or the lips. And this, we're going to go through it, inshallah, in more details when we come to the details of articulation point. This is the end of the lesson. Next lesson, inshallah, we're going to talk about the Arabic letters. Until next time, inshallah, subhanakallah wa bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.